Welcome to the Arts at ODU Summer Series. I'm Cullen Strawn, Executive Director for the Arts at Old Dominion University. The Summer Series was developed to facilitate community connections through free and accessible programming, to highlight the strength and resilience of the arts, and to lift spirits during this challenging time. The ODU community submitted proposals for programs, and this afternoon we continue the series by featuring a program entitled Resilient Stillness. Brittany Harris serves as Assistant Professor of Theater at ODU, and she presents today's workshop about stillness and togetherness to encourage us to find moments of celebration and expression during the COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you, Brittany.
Hey, how's everyone going? Like Cullen said, my name is Brittany Harris, and welcome to Resilient Stillness. I am an assistant professor of theater at Old Dominion, and my area of focus is in race and performance, theater for social change, and also performative community engaged theater. What that pretty much means is that I use the stage as a vessel to promote social resilience and redemption, and to promote the idea of personal narrative as a celebration. And more particularly, it looks at race, but also it can just be experience as well. I was very, very excited to put up this workshop because I believe that the arts is something, along with other things that have been hit during the COVID-19 pandemic, it's been something that's been affected. It has been something that's very personal to me, that I am no longer able to connect via outreach and do my work. So I found myself in need of a place to explore. And I felt very limited in this confine of this box with the Zoom. And I was very excited to see a proposal to put up a way to provide a tool to allow for us to still be connected, but also look at our own expression and feelings of what stillness and resistance looks like individually. So nonetheless, I wanted to give us a platform to explore that. So I want you to take in mind that this workshop is very truncated, but is a way to express what is going on internally, physical embodiment, rather than all the words that keep coming at us. I think we see a bunch of numbers, we see unfortunate cases, we see lives lost, we also see a bunch in medical jargon, a lot of words, and all of those words give us something inside and make us feel something. And sometimes we don't have the words to express them, but maybe we need a place to explore them physically without feeling like I'm not using the right words. So I want to go ahead and flip the script on this boundary. We're going to use this rectangle of a Zoom box to be able to connect our feelings. And we're going to do that standing up, physical, in our bodies. We're going to be putting imagery in our body. This is actually derived from a technique from a Brazilian practitioner, Augusto Bilal's Theater of the Oppressed. It's called image theater. What's really nice about Theater of the Oppressed work that it's meant to motivate people. It's also meant to restore or begin something called true dialogue. So this back and forth of exchanging ideas and backgrounds, and also just providing a space to promote change, to take action. And so that's what I want to do today. So I want some people to play with me. just to know that when I do this call for volunteers, that your camera will be live and your mic will be live, but you will only be asked to explore your own physical comfortability, but you will be seen and you will be asked to reflect inward. I think there's something very rewarding about artistic expression, that there's no right or wrong, but it's unique to you. And that's what I want to give us to do today. So I need some participants. So if you are interested, there is an option to raise your hand. If you raise your hand, we'll go ahead and start fielding you into the room. We're only taking about maybe 7 or 8 volunteers to play today. Like I said, keep in mind, you will be seen. So hopefully you're clothed, but also you just want to come on and play on board. So I see a couple of folks coming on in. I'll just wait for that to get started. awesome. Nice. Great. Awesome. So as those faces are popping up on your screen, I will ask for everyone to just keep in mind that you have the option to stand, you have the option to sit, but this is within your own comfortability, okay? I will kind of guide you and lead you in this exploration. And I will say for those who are still watching, you can still participate. You just won't be seen, but I would love at the end, we will have a time for reflection. I would love for you to come on board and just talk about what you saw. So what was memorable about this for yourself as an audience member, but also I will ask my participants to talk about what it feels like to put yourself kind of out there in this kind of exploration, but also asking to kind of go internal to put something out expressively physically, okay? So I'm gonna start by just talking about the elephant in the room, COVID-19, which is not an elephant, but we all have an affiliation with this. Today, I wanna talk about how that word or words in general make us feel something. It gives us a very visceral connection. We even have a relationship, an affiliation to it. We may have an emotion that's connected to it. And that's usually an internal thing, but sometimes that emotion wants to be an outward expression. So I want you to think about shifting your level of expression. That's just a thought, or if you're a words person, just talking, and you're going to be actually putting that in your body. So I'm going to actually get in a position. You all can see me. I'm going to stand just because I have to stand. I love to stand. But I want you to think about the effects of COVID-19. Now, the effect for some people, actually for most people, is different. Some people may have a very sad maybe effect to it. It may be a positive, like, wow, this is a time for me to explore something that I haven't been able to. We all have a relationship to it. And I want you to bring that personal affiliation to this particular exploration. So remember, there's no right or wrong. It's what you feel. Keep in mind that words have movement as a relationship, and there's an imagery that can come through the body that can extend past just the words that we're going to say. So I will say to my participants, we will be taking some screenshots to create sort of like a visual montage. So I believe that you all were told and aware of that, that this may be placed on our social media pages just to kind of talk about the work of this workshop. And if you don't agree to that, just let us know. We'll definitely edit out those images for sure. But anyway, so like I mentioned before, we've been getting a lot of words at us, like I'm talking a lot right now. But I do want us to now get into a position that you're able to move freely. When you move, I want you to realize that you do have boundaries, right? There are boundaries above you. There's like this rectangle that we're playing within. I want you to think about how your body can extend past that. So I would like for everyone to actually do like a little stretch exercise with me. So go ahead and see how far you can stretch your arms to see if you can touch the frame, right? See if you can get kind of in the middle, see how limited you are, right? And just know that if you do something like this, you may be out of frame. We want to be make sure that you can be seen, okay? Very nice. Look at that movement. Yes, perfect, great. Also, I want you to look at levels, right? So we're just doing lateral. If I go down here, what does that look like within that, okay? So I'm gonna lead you in an exercise and I'm going to name a word, right? It's like a word affiliation. I'm gonna give a word and then I want you to physicalize what that word makes you feel. I'll give you like a countdown of like a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So for instance, if the word is sunshine, I will go sunshine and begin. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then I want you to hold that pose for about 2 or 3 minutes. I mean, seconds. Woo, cha. 2 or 3 seconds, and then release. So that's your expression of that word, okay? So that's just an example. I'll give us one more example, then I'll lead you with the actual exercise words. So let's think of the word joy, okay? You can think about it. Try not to like predict what you're gonna do. I'm gonna do joy like this. Like, no, no. See if you can just come up with it in the moment, but I want you to think about how that word makes you feel, okay? So the word is joy. You will have 5 seconds to get into that position. Remember your framing, your limitations. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold, and release. Love it, love it, love it, love it. Is that clear? Can all my people do like this? So I know that was clear, clear, clear. Great, all right, so back in the mindset of the effects of COVID-19 and your relationship to it, I'm gonna give you some words and I want you to express. I would love to see your imagery behind some of these words, and I'm going to participate with you as well, okay? So the word is, and don't begin until I begin the countdown. The word is stillness. I am going to let my admin team know that we will be taking a screenshot of this final image, okay? So the word is stillness in your relationship to COVID, okay? And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold that, and we can take a screenshot, please. And release. Nice. Great. Here's another word. Limitation. Okay. Let that word resonate. We will not be taking a screenshot of this one. The word is limitation, how that makes you feel, and go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold. I want you to hold this and see if with your eyes you can take a look at the screen and to see our relationship, right? Look at some of the repetition. I see a lot of like hands covering the face or hands affiliated with our heads, or there's some interesting like chemistry and connectivity here. Love it. And release. Good. All right. Your next one is peace. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Release. So I'm gonna do a quick check-in with you all since I have a little time. And I can probably take one or two. I would like to know, is finding the physical to the words an easy thing for you or something that you have to think about more than you thought? Like, for instance, with me, I'm just emotional and dramatic. So I'm always feeling when I'm showing what I feel all the time. I'm happy. I'm always there. I'm always in that position, right? But is it something for you that you had to, wow, how does stillness look? How does limitation look? Did anyone want to speak about that? If you raise your hand, I can call you out and I can turn your mic on. Anyone want to kind of speak about, was it an easy connectivity exercise, or were the two kind of in their own, like, all right, I can find the, I have a word, that word has this, but trying to find the physical relationship wasn't as simple. Anyone? I don't see any hands raised. Oh, that's okay. Well, I will say just for me, usually, like I said, very easy. I'm usually a person that's very much in my body, just with my talent and my nature, I guess. I don't know. I've always been that way. But I will say this is something that I do want to implore, even for the people watching, even if you are, like, say, a practitioner or a teacher, this could be a really nice exercise to help stir up conversation in the classroom. Sometimes the conversation does not come with words. Some people aren't words people. Some people are expressive. Some people draw. Some people sing. So I want you to just keep in mind that this could be a tool that can assist with that. So now I'm going to make this activity a little bit more personal. Great. Oh, yes. Oh, I see. You all were raising your hand in the clicky button. My bad. I meant like literally raise your hand. I'm sorry. Like physically, y'all laughing. I can't. Let's start this again. Let's, by a show of hands like this. Did anyone want to speak to that? I would love. Thank you. I love it. All right. I'll start with Tracy and then Stephanie. And then we'll go on with the next part. My bad.
Okay, no problem. Okay, limitations can cause anxiety a lot of times, especially if you feel trapped and you have no power to go beyond those limitations, but you have to deal with it, so it can cause anxiety.
Absolutely. So how did you find yourself, Tracy, right? That was who was speaking. Tracy, how did you find yourself working through that?
Deep breaths. Because there was not much I could do about the situation, but just trying to think of alternatives, or basically how to work within the limitations per se.
Right.
If I knew I couldn't go beyond what I where I could go, then I had to work around it. So right. You have to come up with a plan B as far as how you're going to rule, or how you're going to go about your life without having to, without being able at this particular place and time, being able to go over those limitations.
Right. Thank you for that. That's a great lesson on life. Absolutely. And what I do appreciate is how this exercise was able to kind of have that analysis, that pull away, that reflection piece on it. There is something very much like taking a deep breath and realizing, all right, there is an alternative to this. There is a way to work within this limitation. It may not come as quickly to some, but I do have my own way to deal with that. So thank you for sharing that. Stephanie.
Hi, Ms. Murphy.
Hi.
I was gonna say some words for me, it was more difficult for me to, for my body to know where to go. For the stillness one, that was very easy for me. But for some reason, when you said peace, I was like, I don't really know how that feels for me. And I think it's because the time we're in right now, it's very hard to feel peaceful. So it was hard for me to know how to find that in the moment.
Right, right.
I guess, yeah, different words have different reactions for different people.
Absolutely. I was going to say, by a show of virtual visual hands, did anyone have issues with peace? Anyone, or something that was kind of, yeah, I found myself like, for peace as well. But I do love this idea of feeling like we need to show peace, right? There's this idea of being a representation and a presentation of yourself, right? This workshop is for you to just be true to you. So you're not trying to be a presentational version of yourself, not the presenting who you are, but being a real authentic representation of you. And sometimes it is a difficulty in finding in your own confines, your own limitations, some peace. So thank you both to Tracy and Stephanie and everyone so far, just for your honesty in that. So now I'm gonna delve a little deeper. This next image that you will be creating is your own. So I'm gonna give you 1 minute to come up with a word on your own that signifies, that represents your own affiliation with dealing with the COVID-19 restrictions, limitations, whatever. I don't wanna like give words to help, but how you relate to it. How are you dealing with it? One word though, one word that then can have an outward expression, and this will be yours. And what we're going to be doing is creating what I call a virtual quilt. So we have these boxes that are here like quilt squares. And each of us on the count of 5, of course, will take on our own physical embodiment of whatever that word is for us. And for that, we will have our own representation under one umbrella. It's gonna be this beautiful way of looking at, while we are kind of disconnected, we are connected, even if it's through these squares or rectangles, okay? So I want you all to just reflect on a word that embodies your relation to it right now. It can be in response to something that happened today, the new limitations that have been placed on this area as of a couple of days ago. I mean, and whatever, you know, so your own personal affiliation. And then I will let you get yourself in a position to present that. So I'm going to stand for mine. Anyone want to change their position? But you will also still have 5 seconds to get into that pose, image, stillness. And then I will say to my admin team, there will be screenshots needed for this in particular, because this is our virtual montage quilt for sure. Okay. So by visual thumbs up, everybody ready? Thank you. Next time, y'all. All right. So again, this is a moment for you. Go ahead and take a clarifying breath. I always do this. It's in for four through your nose, out through your mouth for four. Tracy introduced the power of breath and breathing. Yes, it is. We need it to survive. So in for four and out. One more. And then and out. Now, I will say that you do not have to share your word with us. This is for you, okay? But I would like to see your image. We would. All righty, everybody ready? And out on a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And hold that image. Can we please take some screenshots? And release. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So I'm going to bring this in and I'm going to go ahead and open up to my participants first, and then I'm going to open to the audience for a Q&A. But I would love to just gather some reflection points. We've been working on this for about maybe 15 minutes. It is abbreviated. I would love to play more, but I would love to hear about what was memorable about this kind of experience. How could you see this work being an assistance in your life? You're like, hey, this was fun, but I don't see this working, you know? So I'm curious about your takeaway for so far, just kind of being on screen with seven faces you probably have never seen, maybe some, but being asked to reflect inward and show it, be outward about it. And I will take it by hand. So Kimberly, and is that Kerr? I don't want to make Kimberly. Miss Newbill, got it. And then Andrea. So go ahead, Kimberly.
So for me, this has actually been peaceful. It's been kind of a anxiety ridden day, I think, just with spending too much time today reading different posts and being on social media. So this has actually been a nice distraction and a nice way to just to kind of get calm and feel some peace and know that we're kind of all on the same page with that.
Absolutely. Thank you for that. Thank you.
You had actually started right. So it's Kimitra.
Great.
But I mean, honestly, I agree with what Kimberly was saying. And that's the thing. So even being on Zoom, a lot of times it's like meetings and things along those lines. So even then you still just feel like you have to be on, and this provided opportunity to just be and kind of process those emotions, because I haven't really done a lot of thinking about how I feel in relation to COVID-19. And so I think that is something that is different. It actually makes you take a minute and kind of be more reflective and actually just take the time to breathe. This is the first time I've actually sat today and not been like, okay, I got an appointment. Let me respond to this email. Let me go here. So it's a nice break. And I think it is beneficial to kind of incorporate these things throughout the day, because you just get overwhelmed. It's not as easy to turn off when you're home all day with work.
Thank you for that. Yes, I second all of that. Absolutely. Is it Andrea?
Yes, Andrea. Yeah, it just actually really made me just be in the moment. You know, so often we just so distracted with so many different things, and it just made me just pause for a minute just to reflect on just how important it is to just be still and to just be able to process things without having to run from one thing to another. So this was just definitely a great opportunity, and I really enjoyed it, just reflecting on the words and the importance of just taking time for yourself, even if it's for a few minutes, just to think through some things. So thank you for this opportunity.
Well, you are definitely welcome. Everyone is definitely welcome, and thank you for the bravery. One thing I did have to tell myself is that while I felt like my body was restricted and on quarantine, my creativity was not. And that was something that creating this workshop afforded me the opportunity to explore. So thank you all so much. I'm going to now switch to taking some questions or thoughts from the audience. So I believe that we were going to turn off your screens, but thank you, thank you, thank you. If you have any comments that you want to add or want to send me an email, please let me know. And thank you so much for playing. No, but thank you so much for playing and exploring today. This was an absolute joy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Much heart to y'all. So I would like to open up the Q&A here. Let's see here, see if I can answer these. So we have some questions that are coming from Facebook. Clearly life is happening outside my window right now. So we're just going to, great. So the question is, do you host other workshops locally and how can I attend? I do host workshops. I do, and now a lot of them are virtual. I can be reached through my email address through ODU, which is b1harris@odu.edu. And definitely you can just join, just send me an email and we can find a way to do that. The next question is, how did you transition from performing to a community outreach approach with your art? What's really nice, that's a great question, is that my work has always been influenced by my community. I'm always in response, like a call and response. A lot of my work as an artist was in response to what was coming up on the news, in response to what was in the headlines in my own community, people I knew. So the transition was actually kind of seamless in that regards. But finding the platform, a place to cultivate that, I had to kind of create it. So the importance of understanding narrative and giving a space to explore our own narrative is something that I'm definitely trying to bring and breathe life, especially to the Hampton Roads area. Born and raised from here, y'all. So definitely there's an affinity and connection here. The next question is, where can we view the final piece from today? So this will be on our social media pages, the Arts at ODU Facebook. I believe there will be like a link that shows everything. And I believe that's on that website affiliated with that as well. I'm sure there might be some things through our Instagram page, but primarily just look out for Arts at ODU Facebook page for sure. Last question is, do you have any advice on how to become more involved with local theater, the local theater community? Absolutely. What's really nice, we have a very engaging and open arts community, especially in the Neon District, which is kind of based on Granby Street, right in Norfolk. We have a lot of either visual arts, improvisational arts, actual live theater, equity, professional-based theater as well, based in downtown Norfolk. What I will say is kind of start with reaching out to like your local, if you're part of ODU, your ODU theater community. A lot of us, all of the professors are connected to some of the professional and community-based theater here. But sometimes it does take a quick maybe Google search to type in live theater in Hampton Roads or in Norfolk. That is something that I utilized when I first transferred from VCU to ODU when I came back here, just to how to get involved. But a great way is to utilize your resources with us, even me, I can be a resource, but then also just delving into a quick Google search. So I hope that question helped. Also, Facebook is amazing. Usually if you connect with like say the Arts at ODU or connect with ODU Rep Theater, it'll say suggestion for other theaters in the area. So that's sometimes a good place to start. So I hope that that helped. And that was our last question for today. So again, thank you so much to all the participants that came to Resilient Stillness. I do hope that this was informative. It was something that you were able to reflect inward on and then perhaps take this tool to create some dialogue within your own personal community and family. So thank you so much. And now I am going to actually gear it up for some final words from Cullen Strawn. Thank you.
I invite you to join us for the final program in the summer series, a virtual concert exploring making communal music during a time of physical isolation. To learn more and register, please visit oduartstix.com. That's oduartstix.com. And follow ODU Arts on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for updates. Thank you for joining us.